Special needs student is now at the center of an abuse investigation. The family of the four-year-old boy tells NBC2 he was pinned down by staff members at Lehigh Elementary School until he fell asleep.
For me to send them to school and know that they were being abused, you lose trust.
NBC2's Christina Mendez is live outside the school tonight after speaking to the boy's grandmother.
The grandmother tells me that the trust here is broken. She says the four-year-old is one of three children that were allegedly involved in those abuse allegations that happened here at Lehigh Elementary's preschool program.
Being part of the system as a caretaker, you know, that's the last call you want to get.
Zenaida Yerbina is the guardian of her nonverbal four-year-old grandson, Michael. She says Lehigh Elementary School called warning DCF would be reaching out.
I wasn't getting any answers.
The school allegedly only offered words of comfort.
I repeat those words in my head every day. You know, Michael is fine, and he is very well protected within our walls.
But that reassurance was ripped away after getting a visit from DCF.
There were reports of allegations of an educator physically, you know, harming three students in his classroom.
Michael was one of those three classmates.
We were basically told that Michael was being pinned down by teacher or assistant's knees were forced onto his back to hold him down until he would fall asleep.
The Lee County School District confirms the teacher and paraprofessional have been removed from the classroom. This is a standard practice when there's allegations against the health, safety, and welfare of students.
My biggest thing is Michael, as well as the other children, did not ask to be born with these conditions or these disabilities. See, as adults, we choose our career paths. And for me to send them to school and know that they were being abused, you lose trust.
Yerbina removed Michael from the school.
Michael may not be able to talk. The other kids may not be able to speak. I'm going to fight as much as I can, as far as I have to go, to make awareness and get justice for these kids.
Michael's grandmother wants to thank the person who came forward about allegedly what happened in that classroom. So far, DCF, LCSO, and the school district are all looking into these very serious allegations. Reporting live here in Lehigh Acres, Christina Mendez, NBC2.